Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Real Underground Club King here with vlog number 3. And this is going to be a good story involving the club and the NYPD. And the whole cop sentiment in New York City. We're going to get into that in future vlogs and future stories. But people got to stop with this shit, defund the police. Okay, we need the police. You know, there are good cops, bad cops. There are good and bad in everybody. But NYPD, it's a great police force. And they risk our lives, their lives every day so we could be safe. These liberal fucking assholes, defund the police. We don't want the police, blah, 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 blah. Why don't you just shut the fuck up? Because without the police, we'll have anarchy and we'll have chaos. Okay? And most of the people who want to defund the police are criminals. You know? People need to get themselves back together, stand up. Stop whining like little babies. Stop waiting for your little unemployment and PPE check to arrive. Get back to work. Get back to life. Protect our city. Bring it back to the glorious way it was. The greatest city in the world, New York. I won't go off on a tangent, but we'll be dealing with a lot of topics like that in the city. And this is a fun story on how the police actually did their job. When we had the vault, we were originally on 28 9th Avenue, which was 9th Avenue and 14th Street. It was in a triangle building, which is now a landmark building. When we grew, we moved to 28 10th Avenue, which we had a whole entire building then. We had floors. We had rave parties in the basement. We had the vault. We had couples parties. We had private parties, everything. We ran the whole entire building. So what we decided to do for promotion was we took the whole side of the building and painted a giant, I think it was 75 or 80 foot billboard of the vault. We changed the logo. The original vault logo was the vault spelled out black and white, kind of like dripping, like it was dripping blood. And that was not, you know, when AIDS took over and people were more self-conscious about their health, it wasn't really correct. So we got a new logo, which was kind of sleek. It was orange and black, a straight up V, and it said the vault. And we painted that, had that put on a whole side of the building. It was huge. You could literally see it from a mile away coming down the West Side Highway. And we put floodlights on top of it so you could see it at night. And I think it just said the vault, 28 10th Avenue with the phone number. I think it had a little phrase where fantasies become reality or something. Anyway, that was going really good. People were noticing it. They were talking about it. It was sort of like a landmark where the vault was. So we decided to spice it up a little. And we used to have these mannequins in the vault dressed up like in leather and everything, almost like props, life-size mannequins like you would see in a department store. So we took a male mannequin, dressed him up in leather pants. We put like a hood on him and we hung him off the roof. Not the brightest idea to begin with, but we hung him off the roof in front of the sign. So in other words, you're driving down the West Side Highway, you would see the sign, the vault, and you would see what appeared to be a human body hanging off the roof with a noose around his neck. We thought it was going to be theater and art. We thought it was going to be fun. Nothing came of it. All of a sudden, we get contacted by a couple of cops we knew at the 6th Precinct that said, listen, we've gotten 1,000 complaints that somebody's hanging themselves off the building and they're dead. And the cops were good. We had a lot of cops and firemen as customers. They were really good natured. A lot of times they helped us out a lot. And, you know, they said, listen, you got to get rid of it. You got to get rid of it. People are thinking that you're promoting suicide. And it was just funny. We would joke with them. We said, listen, you know, you guys, crackheads are throwing their babies off the roof. And you're sitting in your car eating cake. And it's like all of a sudden now we became, because Giuliani at the time targeted us. And I was, my family was a fan of Giuliani. You know, I know he was trying to do good, but he targeted us. That's a whole other series of vlogs to get rid of us. Because we were the first underground club that was getting a lot of press and a lot of publicity. Because we were doing a lot for charity. We did charities for pediatric AIDS. We did charities for gay men's health crisis. We did events. And, you know, we were a celebrity-oriented club. And it was a gray area business. And Giuliani, he did a separate press conference. We got to get rid of the vault. Well, anyway, we didn't get rid of the vault, but we got rid of him. Now he's fucking going to jail. Good for him. But anyway, the New York police, we joked with them. We said, you're so efficient now. Now you're stopping, like, theater and art bogus suicides. And they just laughed. And it was just one of the time where they really were, like, were on top of it. They helped us resolve it. We got up on the roof. We we got rid of it, and then we kept moving forward. And it was just a little funny anecdote of all the craziness that happened. You know, you got to buy my book. My book is coming out October 16th, Call the Vault, on Book Baby, and it will be bookstores everywhere, Amazon.com, BookBaby.com, BarnesandNoble.com, and the great stories in the book, but there's another 1,000 stories that have to do with New York City, that have to do with the police, that have to do with clubs, that have to do with corruption. And it's like, you're going to love it, because we're going to take it to a whole new level and drag it right into our podcast, which will probably premiere around November. So I hope you like this story. Please support the channel. If you want to see a picture of the side of the building I was talking about, go to my Instagram, which is nightlife_mogul. And one of my posts, I show a black and white picture of the whole entire building, and you'll see what I was talking about. And check out the Instagram. Support this channel, please. Click down below. Subscribe. And we got a lot of great content coming up for you guys. And, you know, I think it's going to be really informative. Enjoy your day. And we'll see you in the next one. Take care.